Oscar, welcome. Good afternoon, dear colleagues. In this presentation, we would like to highlight the problem of the cardiovascular system in children with scoliosis who receive Shenobrace therapy. The previous colleagues, the Shenobrace has its own peculiarity, which means that in order to correct the rotational component of the spine, we need to apply pressure onto the hooks from the left. The basis of this scientific research are Holter's monitoring as the most informative method in the evaluation of the cardiac rhythm, the variability of the cardiac rhythm due to the time of the day, envisaged by the age peculiarities of the children development, impact of the scoliotic deformity of the chest department of the spine, and the level of expression of scoliosis. The presence in 75% of the scoliosis of cardio anomalies. We can't exclude the impact of different treatment procedures on the correction of scoliosis. In order to study the variability of the cardiac rhythm, the daily ECG, we've conducted the ECG monitoring in 37 children aged from 5 to 16. Holter monitoring was conducted when the children were referred to Oganok with the brace and without the Shenobrace. There was a registrating block, ECG block MN028 number 4778 that was manufactured and approved in accordance with the mandatory requirements of state standards, enforced technical documentation and viable for use. The electrodes were fixed on the body in accordance with the scheme and instruction of using of Holter monitoring. If there was any problems in terms of fixing, we individually re-monitored the brace. In the work, we analyzed standard parameters of 1 and 2 pole ECG registration with quality and quantity hourly registration of the cardio complexes. And we had some episodes of tachycardia, less than 100 frequency, and bradycardia, more than 60 frequency per minute. The analysis of these parameters showed that there was a reverse connection between tachycardia and the age of the patient. We have also seen the slowdown of the rhythm down to 60 per minute and lower in children over 12 years of age, and no bradycardia episodes in patients in the age of 8. Circadian index varied from 1.1 to 1.42 in children up to 8 years. And the sympathetic hyperactivity and tachycardia, the general background, was decreased in those children. In diagnostic search of ectopic disorders of the cardiac rhythm, we use not only information about the arrhythmic episodes detected, but also we conducted the double control, an automatic one, and on the basis of the computerized data and visual ones, in order to exclude the pseudoarrhythmia and artifacts. We have registered what we have registered by the Holter monitor, were the elements of the extreme manifestations of sinusal arrhythmias that were similar to sinoatrial blockage and atrioventricular blockage, but could be taken as normal ECG. In some cases, the findings of the ventricular exosystoles amounted to 140 to 230. No group extrasystole, early episodes of allorhythmic ventricular extrasystole. In two cases, we had episodes of very short-term blistering of the we considered accidental. So we can state here that the standard interpretation of the cardiac rhythm and some components of the complex in the mode of Holter monitoring have not shown visual pathologies. This may be said about the starting of monitoring and the monitoring in the course of the therapy, including the patients with the Shannon worsen. The difference was only in the heartbeat frequency in the group of early age children up to 8 years of age due to the prevailing of sympathetic adrenal adaptation mechanisms. The Holter monitoring during the daytime and evening time was susceptible to tachycardic syndrome in more than 80% of the studies. In most cases, the difference of circadian index was not connected with the degree of the scoliosis, but was only the age peculiarity of the variability of the cardiac rhythm. It should be mentioned that we had a lot of artifacts, especially during the daytime in Holter monitoring, maybe in connection with the excessive physical activity of the patients. In the research of recent years by Makarova and Bayevsky, it was shown that variability of the cardiac rhythm depends directly on the expressionless of neurohumoral mechanisms and emergency adaptation. They have also developed the methods of integral assessment of the variability of the cardiac rhythm, and they have shown the scattergram and the histogram. In our study, we have analyzed this data in the daytime and evening time, and the most informative in terms of the resolution of these tasks. You can see the scattergram, chaos gram, and histogram. The histogram of the scoliosis patients had two modes in daytime and evening time. When we analyzed the peaks, we have not seen any deviation from the norm. On the histograms, especially in the daytime, had a monomodal type with one peak only. In few cases, the apex of the mode was doubled. Here on these drawings, you can see daytime and the evening histogram. In the bottom, on the right, you can see that there is a trend to form the second mode or the second apex. When we analyze the scoliosis patients of third, fourth grade, we've seen the bimodal or two apex picture. The Holter monitoring study in the night time shows the more expressed bimodality, and you can see here daytime and nighttime severe scoliosis patients histogram. You can see in the nighttime three or even more apexes. B and polymodal histograms, the opinion of Makarova and Demidova is characteristic for disbalanced sympathetic and parasympathetic impacts onto the regulatory mechanisms of the variability of cardiac rhythm. They have no direct link to the cardiac centers of automatism. So, at the end of the 90s, Kushakovsky has shown that the impact of this phenomenon to the cardiac rhythm is more informative on the basis of the integral studies of scatter and chaos grams. Pictures 10-13 show data of scatter and chaos grams of the patient with a severe scoliosis, grade 3 and 4. Now, pictures 12 and 13 show the same scat angiogram for the patients with the mild scoliosis. You see that the scatogram for the patients with one and second grade are more elongated compared to the patients of grade 3 and 4 scoliosis. In spite of their comparatively low observations for patients with 3rd and 4th degree, especially in dynamics in the process of therapy. Such therapy as electromagnetic procedures, Shannon brace and physical therapy, we can very definitely state that the disorders of the vegetative regulation of variability of cardiac rhythms is increased. The disbalancing of neurohumoral adaptation detected and its impact on the variability of the cardiac rhythm is limited mainly to sinusoidal and or parasinusoidal arrhythmias without pathologic disorders of ectopic type. We had some sinusoidal arrhythmias only, and this was especially demonstrated when we analyzed scatograms in dynamics. Conclusions: variability of the cardiac rhythm in the course of the day shows sympathetic adrenal type of ECG in the early age group without visible connection with the grade of the scoliosis. The variability of the cardiac rhythm is dependent for 3rd, 4th grade scoliosis patients of the disbalanced neurohumeral links of the extreme emergency adaptation. The Shannon brace increases the vital impact onto the variability of the cardiac rhythm, and the expression of variability, especially during the night time, is increased when we have concomitant cardio anomalies. Thank you for your attention. Thank you. Any questions to the speaker? There are no questions. In that case, let me generalize my presentation. In fact, it's rather difficult for comprehension since it's on cardiology while we are orthopedists. Let me tell that this study enables us to state that Shannon brace doesn't have any negative effect on the cardiovascular system of the child. Up to 70% of children with scoliosis have different cardiac problems. In theory, they manifestate while Shannon brace is used, but it doesn't influence